Hi folks, and welcome back. Today I'm very excited for this particular mushroom. Here you are seeing the brown birch bolete, which is part of the bolete. I'm sorry here, this tree is right in my way. Whew. Lots of mosquitoes here too. So this is the brown birch bolete, and it's a pretty large mushroom as you can see here. That's my hand. It's pretty big. And there's another one. Now, I'm gonna leave this one since this other one here I found already slightly uprooted. And we'll take a look at this one here. Now, the bolete group of mushrooms here don't contain gills, but on their fertile surface here, you can see that it consists of very many pores or almost a spongy-like surface. Now, this one is pretty old. I wouldn't recommend eating this one in particular. As you can see, it's decomposing quite a bit. But that's one characteristic of this brown birch bolete. Another one is it won't have any partial veil around the stem or the stalk. So you can see there's no partial veil. And another characteristic of this one in particular is it'll have a bunch of these little tiny darker spots on its stalk going from the bottom all the way up to the top. That's another characteristic. And those spots are believed to be an actual organ that secretes an oily residue. So just another little interesting feature. And if we come back and look at the top, you can see they do vary in color depending on your region even and the temperature of it. If you live in warmer climates, the mushrooms tend to be, I think, lighter. I'm sorry if I'm getting this wrong, and it doesn't apply to all species, just a few that they did a study on. And if you live in colder climates, your mushrooms are going to be darker. So there can be varieties across species, but generally the top of the brown birch bolete is going to be brown to tan in color. And it is a desirable edible mushroom, in fact. And I will have lots of details on this one as well. And this fungus here is considered to be a mycorrhizal fungus. As you can see here, it's not growing off of any wood or any other type of decomposing material, really. You can see them just popping out terrestrially out of the soil and usually out of mossy areas and very wet areas. So these funguses aren't actually decomposing any material, but they're working. Especially their mycelium are working with the plants and trees in this area and actually exchanging resources with each other, and it's beneficial for the trees and plants. So a lot of these mycorrhizal fungus, I would tend to leave them unless you do see an abundance, because it is helping the trees and the forest, and if you take away too many of them, it might have a negative impact on your habitat. So just keep that in mind. But this is a very desirable mushroom, as they grow pretty big. Although this one I did walk past here a few times and miss, because it's not as colorful. So if I just back away here and just do a quick look by, it is a little tough to see. Once I stopped here for a bit to actually look at a different fungus, then I saw these growing, and I was quite surprised to find them. So pretty neat, the brown birch bolete, part of the bolete family, and it's also considered a mycorrhizal fungus. Very cool stuff. Hope you enjoyed, guys, and we'll be back very soon with more edible fungus. Take care.